We're in the central nervous system. The central nervous system includes the brain and spinal cord. Both of them are well protected. You have the skull, you have the vertebrae column, protect these two. You cannot afford them to get hurt. And you have the peripheral nervous system. Peripheral nervous system, the bundles of axons together is called the nerve. And you have the nerves start from the brain, we call them cranial nerves, and you have 12 pairs. If you took anatomy, you're going to learn those 12 pairs of cranial nerves. And you have the nerves from the spinal cord, we call them spinal nerves, they go to control the peripheral. And our focus is the central nervous system, including your brain, your spinal cord. They are well protected inside because you cannot afford for them to get hurt. And they're in the skull, the temperature is always constant, provide a lot of nutrients to them, like 20%, 15 to 20% of blood go to them. And they have a lot of glucose, a lot of oxygen, and they never physically touch the outside. So they need to receive the signal. The signal comes from your sensory system. In our next topic, when we talk about the sensory system, your five senses, their job is to pick up the outside signal. So your brain never see the light. Your brain never feel the pressure, the temperature, the sound. It's your sensory system, your five senses, they pick up the physical stimulus. And their job is to turn the physical stimulus into the language your neurons are using. That's the action potential. And send the action potential to your central nervous system. So eventually your brain, your spinal cord, all they have is action potential. It's those 0101 signal, we call it a digital signal. We'll talk more about this in our next topic. And your brain not just stay there to make you feel happy. Your brain have very important job to do, which is to keep you alive. And the longer you are able to survive, the longer you survive, the higher chance you have to pass your gene to next generation. And this is the eventual goal of your central nervous system. We have a very complicated central nervous system, but the goal is exactly the same compared with the other animals' goal. So all the animals, they want to survive, and they can pass their gene to next generation, because no animals can survive forever. And we have a very complicated central nervous system, 100 billion neurons. And compared with cockroach, their central nervous system is pretty simple. And they have reflex. So if you want to kill a cockroach, you will run away. Pretty much this is their job. And the goal are exactly the same. So the central nervous system will control the output. The output is the motor output. And you have the somatic motor neuron. This is the one control your skeletal muscle. And also you have the one not under your voluntary control. It's called the autonomic nervous system. It will control your smooth muscle, control your gland, control your cardiac muscle. So they're going to control this and increase your chance to survive in this world. And that's the purpose of the central nervous system. Your central nervous system is a pretty busy place. You have 100 billion of neurons. And you have glia cells. Glia cells are like those supporting cells. They are not neurons. They don't generate the action potential. But they have different job. Like we talk about the oligodendrocyte. That's the cells produce the myelin. You totally have six different kinds of glia cells. And actually, you have 10 times more glia cells compared with neurons. Okay, spinal cord. We start from the spinal cord. This is a cross section of the spinal cord. This is the dorsal, this is the ventral. So this is close to your back, this is to your belly, right? So the dorsal part and the ventral part, the spinal cord look like a butterfly. Some people call it the Honda logo. I think both of them are correct. So the inside, this butterfly is gray, they call it the gray matter. Outside is white, so that's the white matter. Why is white? Because it's myelinated axon. So in the spinal cord, the neurons, the cell bodies, stay in the gray home. So this is why they look gray. They're not myelinated. So this is all the cell body. And their axons stay on the white part. So this white part, they call the tract, central nervous system. They don't call the nerve, they call the tract. It's exactly the same as nerve, a bundle of axon. They send the information up and down. So they send the information to the brain, and from the brain go down. This is in the white matter. And these are the gray matter. This is where the cell body is located. So in the dorsal part, it's called the dorsal horn. That's the sensory input move in, like when I shake your hand. You can feel it. The sensory input is from the dorsal. This is dorsal root ganglia, a cluster of cell body. This is the sensory neuron and goes through the dorsal horn, send information in. And of course, you're going to go up to your brain so you can feel it. But it also go to the ventral horn. Ventral horn, this is the motor output. So you're able to shake hands with me. You need to have the motor control. So the motor neuron cell body stay in the ventral horn and their axon stand out. Through the ventral root, move out. So if I ask you, okay, if I cut the ventral root, what kind of damage you can have? Could you feel your hand? The answer is yes, because you still have the sensory, right? Could you control your muscle? The answer is no, because that's the ventral root. So that's the function difference, dorsal and ventral. Let's look at the lateral. Lateral is your somato nervous system. So your autonomic nervous system, they stay in the lateral horn. The output, they only have this part output, this part input. So their input still goes through the dorsal root. And just the autonomic function staying here. And their motor output, if they want to go to control, say your heart muscle, increase your heart rate, they still go through the ventral root and move out. The function of your spinal cord is reflex. You don't use your spinal cord to think. That's your brain's function. So the spinal cord's function is simple, straightforward, and quick. Its function is like you touch something hot, you quickly move your hand back. We call this reflex arc. Very quick, very efficient. You don't have too many elements. And we actually talk about this in the reflex pathway, right? So you need to have a receptor, sense the temperature is pretty hot. And you're going to have the more sensory neuron. The green one is the sensory neuron, also called efferent. You're going to move in and through the dorsal root. And now you have the interneuron. Interneuron is here. Your integrating center is brain or spinal cord. This time is spinal cord. And you're going to have the motor output from here, also called efferent. That's the output. So the blue one is the efferent. Going to go to contract, ask your skeletal muscle to contract. When you contract your muscle, you move your hand back. That's the response. So this is a very simple pathway. You only have five elements. And it's simple, it's quick. So you can decrease the damage. Efficient, that's their function. Now let's look at the brain. The brain, we have the original brain. Human's brain is like the original brain. Sometimes you found scientists call it the lizard's brain. That's this part. And on the top of it, you put on the fancy, super powerful computer. That's the cortex. So divide into different lobes, L-O-B-E, lobes. And the connection between them is this part. It's called the diencephalon. Diencephalon is the connection. Diencephalon including thalamus, hypothalamus, and epithalamus. That's this area. That's the connection part. So let's start from the lizard's brain. It's called the lizard's brain because, well, the low-level species have it, including the midbrain, the pons, and medulla oblongata. So it's also called the brainstem, this part. Brainstem, midbrain, pons, medulla oblongata. And this area, their function is very original physiological function. They control your pupil reflex, control your breathing, control your heart rate. And if this area been damaged, this patient probably won't be able to make it. That's why in the ER, you may see the TV or the movies, the doctor will take a flashlight, shine on the pupil. They're checking this part's function. And when we talk about the cardiovascular system, the respiratory system, and we're going to talk about the CVCC, Cardiovascular Control Center, the RCC, the Respiratory Control Center, and you found they're all located here, pons, medulla oblongata. So that's the original brain. And now let's look at the diencephalon. Diencephalon, that's this part. Diencephalon's function is connect the original brain to the fancy super powerful computer. That's the cerebral cortex. It has a thalamus. There's a thalamus. So thalamus is like a train station. All the information move to your cortex from your body, gonna go to the brainstem. From the brainstem, gonna go to the thalamus. From thalamus, go to the cortex. So it control the input and output. And thalamus can be divided into different sub area. Like one area gonna send information to the visual cortex, and one gonna send the information to the auditory cortex. It's like a train station. This area is called the hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is not the thalamus, even though it's part of the diencephalon around here. Hypothalamus has a lot of function. When we talk about the endocrine system, it controls the pituitary gland. So it releases a lot of trophic hormone, 9 different kinds of trophic hormone. It also controls your body temperature. Like your body temperature is regulated by hypothalamus. So when you have fever, it's actually your hypothalamus. Make your body temperature higher, and because it believe it can prevent the bacteria to grow, so it's a protective mechanism. And when you set the temperature to 102 degree, then all your body gonna work very hard to reach 102 degree. And when you don't reach 102 degree, you feel cold. So that's you're gonna put jacket on to reach 102 degree. And that's what happens when people have fever. You found why they put it's so hot outside and they put a heavy jacket on. They still feel cold, they're shivering. And because their body tried to reach the 102 degree, the hypothalamus set. So your body temperature is set here. And also in unit 1, we talk about osmolarity. It's also controlled. You have the hypothalamus, you have the osmol receptor in hypothalamus, control your osmolarity. And your thirst, your sexual desire, hunger, and they're pretty much controlled here. So hypothalamus, very important brain area. So that's the diencephalon. Corpus callosum, that's the connection between your two hemispheres. So now we reach the fancy brain. It's called the cortex. The cortex, you have two hemispheres, the left hemisphere, the right hemisphere. And they were connected together by the corpus callosum. And it's all white. This structure is like a few centimeters. It's all white, means this is all axon. This is all axon. So your left hemisphere, right hemisphere, especially for human, we have lateralization. Human's brain, the left brain, the right brain, they have a little bit different function. And sometimes you hear people say, oh, you are a right brain person, you're very emotional, you're good at art. And you are the left brain person, you are very good at math. So the left brain and right brain has a little bit functional difference. Like the language, human language function only exists in the left brain. And you never feel like you have two persons have different personality living in your head, try to take over your body's function. And the reason is we have corpus callosum. So your left brain and right brain communicate pretty well. And now we reach the super powerful computer, we call them lobe. This is called the cerebral cortex. And it's all gray. It's all gray. So gray matter means that's where the cell body is located. So you have a lot of neurons stay in the cerebral cortex. That's the outside part. And this cerebral cortex, the more neuron you put in, the smarter you are. And you say, well, let's make the head super huge, right? You look like Hello Kitty. No, this won't happen because the human's head is the biggest size we can have and still be able to pass through the birth canal. So Hello Kitty's mom really have difficulty to give birth to her. So we cannot increase this. This is the biggest size we can have. So human's head is the biggest one we can have compared with all other species. And they increase the wrinkle. So they put a lot of wrinkles. You don't want to have wrinkles, but this is the wrinkle you want to have. So if your cortex looks smooth, means you are not very smart. So you have a lot of wrinkles to increase the surface area. And when they take the cerebral cortex out, expand it, it's actually a baby blanket. That's pretty impressive. You put the baby blanket size into the skull. And the cerebral cortex can be divided into different lobes. So each lobe have different functions. So we're going to talk about those different lobes, frontal, parietal, temporal, occipital lobes, and each one of them, what's their function. Okay, let's take a break.